Hi guys, we start the last series of the small letters and we start with the letter Q. So now I'll tell you the breakup. It's like the letter A. You can see this is almost like the letter A, and then standing line. And what you need to practice is this. This is thin line, then a curve, and then a thin line. A slanting curve, basically. So this forms our letter Q. Then we go to our next letter. This is the thin line and this is also thin. Remember, these two are thin lines. We go to our next letter, which is letter R. That's also pretty easy. Thin line, thick line, and then it is almost similar to what we did here. So what the breakup is: thin line, standing line, and then this is thin line. You can say a thick line in the form of a curve, and then a thin line. So basically it is like this. This is R. Then S is very simple. It is almost like the letter S we write in English. You see the way my nib is moving. Now the next letter is letter T. This is also pretty simple. Just a standing line, then a thin line in the end, and in between a sleeping thick line. That's it. This is the letter T, and as you can see, it is very simple. Standing, thick line, then a thin line, sleeping line in between. I hope I don't have to show you the breakup now, because it's very simple. We move on to the next letter, and that is our letter U. U is a thin line, then a standing thick line, slanting thin line, then thin, thick, and thin. I'll show you the breakup once again. Thin, thick, thin, thin, thick, and thin. This is the breakup. So ultimately, this is our U. Then we move on to our V. V is like this. A thin line, thick slanting line. This is a thin line, then a curve, and this this touches the letter in the end. So this is the way it is, the breakup. You have to practice this thin line and the curve. Thin line and the curve. So if you practice that, you will get the letter V very easily. After this, we move to towards our next letter, which is the letter W. This is thin line. This is thick line. Again, a thin line, thick line, and end is like the letter V. So it is, you can see the breakup. This is thin line. This is again thin line. The rest to a slanting thick line. And then this is thin, curve, thin line. So this is the letter W. Then we move on to our next letter, which is letter X. This is thin line, this is thick line, and then thin line. And the next one is, it's a little thick line, then a thin line, and then a little thick line. This I have made to show you the breakup, and this is not bigger. The size of both are almost same. This is X. And then we move on to our next letter, which is Y. Thick, thin line, thick, and then again thin line, which goes up, and then thin, standing thin, and a curve. So basically the breakup of this is thin, standing thin, and then a curve. So this is the way Y is there. And then we come to the last letter, and that is the letter Z. This is a thin line. Wait, let me just finish this and then I will give you the breakup. Thin and a curve, then a thin line, and then a curve and a thin line. So simple. So we finished with the third and the last series of small letters of Chancery Cursive. Next series we are going to start with a decorative style. So till that, keep watching.
So that's it for today. If you like the video, please like, share, subscribe, leave a comment, and click the bell icon to get notifications on every new video we make. Thank you for watching.